Hi, this is Diane Lovetobake on YouTube. And what we're going to make is French bread. Now we're gonna make, I already made one loaf already because you can get two loaves out of this recipe. And I have other French bread videos, recipes on. And then I have a lot of Italian different breads also that start off with starters and that kind of thing. So if you don't like this particular recipe for this French bread, please you know, check out my channel. First off, I'm going to give you all the ingredients because I no longer put them below my video. So you're going to need 1.5 cups of water. And I like to heat mine actually in a cup in a microwave to at least about 140 Fahrenheit. You're going to need 1 package of dry yeast, and that usually is 2 and 1/4 teaspoons of dry active yeast, or 1 package. 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar, 1 tablespoon of solid shortening, which again, I actually put that in the cup with water in my microwave. So I melt the shortening and the water combined. It works well for me. If you prefer not to, you can, you know, you don't have to. 1.5 teaspoons of salt. 4 cups, and we're using just all-purpose flour. We're not using bread flour or anything like that, just your all-purpose flour. And 1 egg that you'll probably want to use the white or the whole egg for actually, you know, covering it before you put it in the oven. Now, if you want to put some sesame seeds on top, feel free. But again, this bread that I'm giving it to, a friend of mine cannot eat seeds. She can't eat seeds and she can't eat nuts. So I make a lot of different recipes for her. And so I'm leaving out sesame seeds. But you can put them on top once you glaze it. I like to glaze it with my egg wash and then sprinkle them on the top. Now you're going to bake it at 375 degrees, and it can take you anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes depending on your oven. So I'll mention some of the other recipes too as I go along. I mean the ingredients, I should say. Now I went ahead and made this dough on the dough cycle on my bread machine. You can make it by hand if you prefer. I like to use the bread maker because I think that it comes out, it's consistent all the time, it's easier for me, and it's just, it's kind of a no-brainer to make my bread dough in my bread maker on the dough cycle. Now this is half, so you get 2 of them this size, okay? This is only half, so I'm going to just put a little flour on my countertop. And what you'll want to do is you'll want to roll it out to about 8 by 15. I mean, it doesn't have to be exact, but it works well for this recipe. It's a very easy dough to handle. Whoops. It's not a real wet dough, which I don't particularly like to work with because I think it's harder to work with that type of dough. It's not a real dense or heavy dough once it's baked up. Okay. Let me put a little flour here because everything's kind of sticking right now. Okay, so, all right, that's about it. It doesn't have to be, you know, perfect. If you're one of those folks that you like everything to, you know, it has to be, you know, perfect, then, you know, feel free. Let me get that out of the way here. And what you want to do is just, I'm going to roll it this way so that you can see it probably better that way. Start rolling the long end jelly roll style. And of course you're going to need a baking pan, and you will need to lightly grease your pan. I'm going to go ahead and use one of these, and what I usually do is I just like to spray it with my oil spray. And, you know, just roll it up as evenly as possible, the same amount of tension if you can. I really don't worry so much if my bread, you know, isn't just perfectly the same size all around. I really don't worry too much about that, but I worry more about the taste and that kind of thing. And now I'm just taking the seam and pinching it, and then I'm going to lay it on the on its side here. And then on closing it, I actually just push down the center. I bring one side over to the other, and then I flip it up almost like I'm wrapping a package. There are many different ways to do it. This is the way that I do it. So you probably have maybe a better way of doing it, then, you know, feel free. And then I just fold it over on both sides and then bring up the end, and then I just press it in again. Till it forms a shape. And this is where you can, you know, if you were worried that you didn't have all of the 15 inches, that you can kind of stretch it out and even out the bread. And then I'm going to just grab a little knife here, because I'm going to put some slashes about a quarter inch into the bread. Like that. I like this particular bread because, well, who doesn't like French bread? Or when, especially once it comes out of the oven, and then to put butter on it or some honey on it. Oh gosh, it just tastes delicious. Smells great when it's baking. Now, once it, you know, whatever pan that you're using or whatever, in fact, I'm going to spray that again because it looks a little light. So I'm just going to just slightly spray. Okay. And then I'm just, I lay it down like that and position it the way that I want it to be. And then I like to just put a clean kitchen or linen towel over it. Now, you can put your egg wash after it's risen, or you can put it on right now. And I think I'd rather do it right now so that you can see me doing it. And then just with my brush, I'm brushing on that egg wash. It can be a full egg. It can be, if you have egg, just want to use an egg white and a little bit of water. That works really good too. And then just paint it like that. Put that aside. And then, like I said, I just put a towel over it and wait till it's doubled in size. And if your kitchen is more on the warm side or whatever, it might come up in 45 minutes that it doubles in size. It might take an hour. Really depends where you put it in your kitchen. Let me wash my hands quickly because I'm working with raw egg here, because I'd like to show you the finished product of this bread. It is really relatively so quick to make. It really is. Let me grab this to show you. Okay, and this is how it bakes up. It really bakes up to a beautiful golden brown, okay, on the top and on the bottom, okay? And let's cut into it so that you can see the crumb on it. Okay, now let's do this end, I think. We'll cut it off diagonally here. Okay, I want you to see the inside, and when I press on it, how it comes back. It's so light and so delicate. It's not a real heavy, dense. It does have, a crisp top and bottom. Let me show you. In fact, let me see if, I hope that you can see that and how it's springing back. It's so light and so delicate. And then let me just take a little bit of the flake away the crumb of the bread that maybe you can kind of get an idea. Oh, it's absolutely delicious. Let me cut another little diagonal piece here to show you. Really, absolutely, there's that spring in it. Oh, what a great tasting bread. It is so good eating it cold, warming it up, eating it right when it comes out of your oven with butter. It's really a fantastic tasting French bread, and it's really pretty easy to make. Let me quickly run over those ingredients for you, being I'm not listing them anymore under the video. You would need 1.5 cups of hot water, at least at about 140 degrees Fahrenheit. 1 package of dry active yeast. That's usually 2 1/4 teaspoons of dry active dry yeast. 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar. 1 tablespoon of solid shortening. 1.5 teaspoons of salt. And 4 cups of just your regular all-purpose flour. And then however you want to do the egg wash, or just the white of the egg with a little bit of water. And then if you want to sprinkle, any type of seed or sesame seed, or just leave it plain like this one. It's a great tasting bread. I want to thank you for watching Diane Love to Bake on YouTube. I'm sorry that I don't put the recipe below, but I mention it in all my videos. I don't do that any longer because so many people are taking my work and posting it and putting it all different places, and it's so frustrating when you write to me or have a question or a comment and I can't answer you. So it's just not worth the time anymore, and I'm certainly not alone on that. So I want to thank you for watching. If you're so inclined and you'd like to subscribe to the channel, I'd really appreciate it, or give it a like or ring the bell. I can't thank you enough for watching Diane Love to Bake on YouTube, and give this French bread recipe a try. If you do and you like it, again, please leave me a comment. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks again. Stay well, stay safe. See you soon.